207 killed and nearly 500 injured in a serious attack in Sri Lanka on Easter Sunday. New at 10, 41 Action News reporter Kat Reed talked to a Metro family whose loved ones are in Sri Lanka tonight. Kat, how are they doing?
Stephen, thankfully they are okay tonight, but the man I spoke with grew up next to one of the bombing sites. It took him 6 hours to get in touch with his family. That was especially difficult since the government shut down access to Facebook and other messaging services. Tonight, he is praying for Sri Lanka.
On Easter Sunday, Anjelo and Mary Delile awoke to these images.
Just really shocked me. I was shaking.
Delile grew up in Colombo. His family is still there, and they were in church Sunday morning.
Everyone took off running in panic. They didn't know if their church was going to get hit.
Their place of worship was safe, but another church and three hotels in the city were targeted.
They were needing a lot of blood at the hospital.
Yep.
Because it's all the patients and people were lining up all over the streets to donate blood.
The scenes playing out were also hard for Hassan Latif to see.
Kind of makes you sick that people can't go out and, you know, celebrate their holy days.
Latif is president of the Crescent Peace Society. It's a nonprofit working to enhance understanding of Muslim cultures in the Kansas City area. While no one has claimed responsibility for the attacks, Sri Lanka's defense minister blamed religious extremists. Latif felt the need to speak out immediately.
There's a lot of people that the conclusion is that it would be somebody who's Muslim. And so we just want to make sure people know that, you know, this is not something that we condone or support. This is like definitely completely against what our religion teaches us.
That's a message the Crescent Peace Society sadly finds itself repeating frequently.
We just have to keep doing it, and so that like gets frustrating, but we want to be the ones that make sure people know how we feel.
The Deliles are slowly receiving messages from their friends in Colombo, learning they're okay. But the attacks have them questioning how safe Sri Lanka is for their family.
We want to take our son to meet his family,
yep,
all of his family back home.
And go to church especially.
And yeah, it's scary.
And U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo said the attacks killed several Americans. We don't know any specifics about those victims yet. Stephen.
Kat, thank you.